You had six blocks tonight. Could you discuss that in the big block against their three-pointer?
Man, just trying to be in the right place at the right time. We happened to switch that one on top of the key, and he let it fly, so having a good hand up and get a piece of it, so that was good.
Devontae, so much talk all year about toughness, being competitive, gritting it out, that kind of stuff. You feel like that was on display tonight?
Oh, I definitely felt like we was tough tonight, more tough than we were last game for sure. Just playing together and wanting to win.
Devontae, what do you think of Mitch's play? I mean, 7 rebounds, 6 blocks.
He got game ball for sure. He was ready to come off the bench and produce. Dope got in foul trouble. And all coach asks of him is just to play hard and protect the rim and do little things to help us win, and he definitely did that tonight.
Was that mindset important early? You got the big lead early, but surely that's what you guys wanted to do, come out like that.
Yeah, we talked about it in the locker room, coming out to a good start. Couldn't have the same start we had the last game, which was terrible. So we just wanted to come out and kind of, you know, punch him in the face first and just take that momentum and keep riding.
What do you think of the job Marcus did tonight, defensively especially?
He do a lot of good little things that, you know, that don't show up on the stat sheet per se, but he do a lot of things like box out, not let his man get the rebound. He kept 34 off the glass a ton and little stuff like that. He got the foul at the end, just from boxing out all the way to the 3-point line. So just little things like that coach noticed and it helps us.
Devontae, because of TCU's win against you guys in the Big 12 tournament and how well they did, did you take them any more seriously this go around than maybe you guys had in the past because of how well they've done lately?
I mean, not because of last year, but just because of this year and their record this year and what they've done. And I'm not sure what their rank, what? 16th ranked team in the nation. So that just, right there, it just tells you you got to take anybody serious, you know. So, and we don't got time to be taking no team serious. We in one of the best conferences out there, and I feel like it, top to bottom, everybody's good.
How do you feel like you've been more aggressive driving the ball these last two games?
I'm trying to be. That's really what I've been focusing on, is just trying to get in the paint, get to the foul line, get easy baskets, and make plays for others.
What happened on the fall when you got the steal and the layup?
I just landed on my butt wrong.
Yeah.
Mitch, did anybody say anything to you after the three that you made?
Coach said he knew as soon as the first one went in, another one was going to go up. But congratulating me on a good game and appreciate my teammates.
Mitch, they do a lot of good stuff with the big guys rolling the basket, the pick and roll stuff. And it seemed like maybe the first 30 minutes you guys defended that pretty well, then Brodziansky started. What happened to change at all there? Or just because of the foul trouble?
They started to set them way deeper into the paint. Like the one they set with Robinson, Brodziansky, towards the end, I think he set it on D-Tay, and that was like on the second hash mark, and it's kind of hard for your low man, roll man to get there, because once he comes off that, it's pretty open.
Mitch, when they cut it to one, what was the mood in the huddle?
Gotta get a stop.
I mean, they took the lead too, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, the whole thing with our team is getting stops. We pride ourselves on playing defense, and we did a better job of that tonight. And I felt like we were all bought into defending.
Devontae, down the stretch there in the last 2 minutes, it so seemed as though you just really wanted the ball, that you enjoyed that kind of moment.
Definitely. I feel like, if anything, the ball should be in my hands to make plays down the stretch late. And I was getting fouled and definitely wanted to be the one to free the line to try to ice the game.
Mitch, did Udoka tell you anything after he fouled out?
Told me to go out there and play hard, and kind of what I tried to do. But we just stuff about their big man and how we need to make sure we were taking away his left shoulder and get the rebounds and stuff, because there's nobody else out there that's big man.
How important was Udoka early? It seemed very obvious you guys wanted to get him going.
Yeah, that was what we said, come out and get him going early. You know, we drew the first play for him, and just to get him going, you know, because he's too big, can't nobody really guard him down there, and you just want to get him his motor going early.
Devontae, about Marcus, he kind of struggles offensively sometimes, but those two free throws he made, pretty big and clutch.
Yep.
Is that show that he's got that, if the game's on the line, he can make a shot.
Definitely. He's actually a pretty good offensive player. I was actually getting on him a lot about not shooting the ball, because in practice he shoots the ball and he makes shots. So I was actually really, really kind of mad at him for not taking those wide open shots, especially when TCU was like not even like guarding him, which was real disrespectful. I feel like he's a pretty good shooter, but he just do the little things, like I said, to help us win. And if he felt like it was a bad shot, he's not gonna take it. So,
Devonta, do you get the feeling that fans are expecting you guys not to win the Big 12 title this season and this run? Do you get the idea that fans eventually think this is gonna be a team that's not gonna see that the streak is gonna end this year?
No chance.
No way.
I don't think our fans. Maybe other teams. I feel like that's every year though, that everybody douses and thinks, oh, Kansas is not gonna do it this year. But you know, it's really we a family. We sticking our huddle and our coaching staff. We all believe in each other and ourselves. So we just go out night in and night out and compete. And hopefully at the end of the year it'll work out for us.
I think this can kind of be a grow up game or mentality wise anyway. You don't have to remind yourself to start fast and start with that energy. I mean, you've been talking about it most of the year. Do you think that can settle in tonight and be, hey, this is just how it has to be? Mitch?
Oh, yeah, that's definitely a big thing with us, because how we started with Texas Tech, I mean, that wasn't a great start for us, but we came out here today and we were ready from the jump, and Udoka played really well early. Got a couple of, we had our first like 6 points or something like that. That's a good thing when Udoka's feeling good, and that'll make him hustle more and
sure.
get loose balls. But just when we get a good start early, it's kind of makes us way more of a deadly team.
You think this will get you to the point where you don't maybe have to remind yourself to do that?
Yeah, I mean, just
some success
breeds confidence. So just think we're gonna take that and go forward with it.
All right, fellas.